Hello everyone, in this video, we are going to demonstrate our CS207 DBMS project named Honeycomb. This is group 14 comprising of me, Rahul, Rishabh, Saket, Yash and Shivish. So Honeycomb is an interactive platform for buying, selling and renting any student's resources within the IITI community. The web application's closer to IITI students would provide a better platform for students to share their belongings. Students can sell or rent their notes, books, stationeries, furniture, and many more. Like for example, if a student is going to graduate, he can easily sell off his belongings to a fresher. So let's start our demonstration. So this is the login page. We are first going to create a new user. So we will click on create one. We can easily fill our credentials. This username will be helpful for logging in the user. We have also set a few constraints over the password so that it can be more secure. So as soon as we click sign up, we will land up on home page, and from the right drop down menu we can easily log out and check that whether our user is active or not, like whether it has been created or not. So here we log in with the user credential we just made. This is home page, and over to Saket for further demonstration.
The homepage is the first screen which the user sees after a successful login. The homepage consists of the recent 8 products listed by the seller. And the homepage also consists of a navigation bar which has a few quick links, like link to the About Us page where we can find insights about the site and the developer. The Buy page where a user can buy any product they need. The Sell page where the seller can post an ad about a product which they wish to sell or rent. The Contact Us page, where anyone can give suggestions or their feedbacks about the site to the developer. Next, there is a search bar where users can search for their product they need. The right-hand side is a drop-down list which consists of your profile page, where the user can see his profile and his credentials. Next is the your wish list page, where the user can see the product he wish listed. And then there's the Your Orders page, where he can see his successful transactions done on the site. And lastly, we have the Your Ads page, where he can see the ads posted by him. The About Us page gives the basic briefing about the project and the developers. As this is an open source project, we have also provided the GitHub repo link here, so anyone who wishes to contribute can directly access the link and reach to the project. And hereby we have mentioned our team which has made this project.
So this is the buy page where user can browse through various products which are listed by the sellers. Several categories are available in the drop down menu.
So here I have selected all categories. So all products are shown here. Also, I can select categories from the left side menu. For example, if I choose household, then products related to household items will be shown. Such as in this case, a mattress, an electric kettle and a bucket are there. And if I select stationery / equipments category, some stationery items and equipments are shown, such as lab coat, drafter and square sets. And at the last, we have recommended items, which gives fresh recommendations to our users.
And by clicking on a product, the individual product page opens. And if he wishes to buy or rent the product, he can click on buy now. Or if he wishes to add the product to wishlist, then he can do so by clicking on the add to wishlist button. users can also browse the products through the home page. By clicking any product, the same item page will open and show the description about the product and the price, whether it is renting price or the selling price, will be shown here. So if he wants to rent the product, he clicks on rent now and a model will pop up showing whether he wants to confirm the deal. And if he wants to confirm the deal, then he'll click on yes. A mail will be sent to the seller notifying that a buyer request has been made, and to the buyer we'll send a mail that we have notified the seller. This is the mail that the seller will get, that this and this user has sent your buyer request for the product football. This is the mail that the buyer will get, that we have notified the seller about your request for the product. You can also contact him through his phone number, and the phone number of the seller will be displayed.
The sell page. Sellers can post an ad for their product on this page. They need to provide a title and description for the product. They can choose to either sell or rent the product and set a price for the same. They can choose the category of the product. The seller needs to upload minimum one image or up to three images of the product. Now the ad will be shown on the home page. The seller can choose to edit the ad, delete or mark as sold the ad. The contact us page. It provides a contact info. This page allows the end user to get in touch with the developers and provide the valuable feedback. The seller has to fill a form with their name, email address and the subject of their feedback. The seller then types the message and clicks on submit. When a user submits the form, the developer receives an email with their feedback.
This is the search bar. From this search bar, user can search for the products. For example, if the keyword provided by the user is found in the product's name or the description or category, then the product is displayed on this page. For example, if we search for book, then the notes, all the books are displayed. In the other case, if the keyword does not match with the database, then no search result will be shown. So this is the profile page. In this page, all the user information is shown, all the general and the login security information. Also, the user can change the information from here. For example, if the user want to change his password, he can change the password from here. So here in the login and security section, if we type our old password and a new password, so if we type the wrong old password, it will show an error. Also, when the new password and a new password confirmation is not same, it will also show an error. For example, this, it will show check for any errors and try again. Also, we have many constraints for the new password so that the password is more secure. Here we are changing our password. If there is no error, then it will show the password has been changed successfully. Also, for security purposes, the password is also hashed. We can also change our general information such as our email and phone number. Then it will show your profile has been changed successfully.
So this is the your ads page. Here all the products put up by the seller are shown. So I have logged in through the seller account to demonstrate this functionality. The seller can edit the ad, delete it, and mark it as sold and then delete. So if he clicks on edit ad, he can edit the description, the whether he wants to sell rent monthly or weekly, and can change the selling or rental price and the category of the product. These changes will be displayed here. And if he wants to mark the product as sold and delete, so a model pops up and shows all the buyers that have previously requested for this product. He can choose to which buyer he sold the product and can then mark as sold. And then the product will be removed from this list and will be added to the your orders list of the buyer.
So in the your orders page, the buyer can see all the transactions completed by him, and these products are listed when the seller has marked the product as sold. So these are all the products which are marked as sold by the seller. For example, as Rishabh just marked the football as sold, this product appeared in my your orders page, and as I click the details, I can see that this product has been sold out. We have also added wishlist functionality for the user. He can wishlist the product or remove the product from wishlist from either home page, buy page, or individual products page. Each of these pages has an indication whether the product is wishlisted or not. All the products wishlisted by the user can be seen in the Your Wishlist page in the right drop-down menu. On this page, user can directly buy the product or even delete the product from the wishlist. So this is all for the demonstration of our project. This project is made using Django, and we'll be very delighted to have your opinions and your suggestions for this project. And the GitHub page is always open for collaboration. And that's it from our side. Thank you.